Hello everyone. In the last session, we discussed the impact of tourism on the economy of a country. Today, we'll discuss something about the environmental impact of tourism. Again, in the same manner, the impact can be positive or negative on an environment. The positive impacts of tourism on the environment are financial contribution, improvement in environmental planning, raising environmental awareness, and protection and preservation of environment. Negative impacts are depletion of natural resources, pollution, destruction of ecosystem, physical impacts, and global level impacts. Let's discuss the positive impacts one by one. Financial contribution. Revenue can be generated from national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, zoological parks, etc. by imposing entry fee plus taxes on the tourists who want to visit these places. Additional services can be provided to the tourists on payment basis to generate revenues. In addition to the entry fee, special fee for environmental protection can be added or levied on the tourists. There are indirect sources of revenue generation also. As everybody knows that there are adventure sports like river rafting which require licensing. So a license fee can be imposed on the tourist as well as the people who are providing these services. Obviously, if people are earning, they'll have to pay an income tax. There are certain sports like river rafting, mountain climbing, paragliding, which requires equipment. And if people want to buy equipment, there is taxes on equipment, recreational equipment also. In our case, it's GST. Tourism improves environmental planning. If a destination or place has the potential to become a tourist spot, we must plan in advance. But what to plan? The two A's, accommodation and accessibility. And the economic impact says infrastructural development. Why to plan in advance? Because a plan in a haste is a waste. We may end up doing costly mistakes by uprooting trees unnecessarily. So we need to avoid these costly mistakes, and this can be done through planning in advance. We can prevent gradual degradation of environmental assets, and the accommodation that are hence built up there, like hotels or accommodation for tourists, or the other services that are provided, can use cleaner production techniques. Raising environmental awareness. More number of people coming to a destination, more awareness you can spread. It's directly proportional. Now, it increases the public appreciation of environment and also spreads awareness regarding environment. Hence, we can start off with ecotourism. Protection and preservation of environment. Identification and development of national parks. By doing this, we can preserve the habitats and biological diversity of the area, and also we can preserve the green belt, also called as forests. Let us discuss the negative impacts of tourism one by one. Depletion of natural resources. More number of people who visit an area require a lot of services, a lot of natural resources like simply water, clean water to drink, and for other services, hotels require water for food production, for washing clothes, anything and everything. Water is required in tourist destination. So there can be water shortage. Wherever there are people visiting, we require food, energy in terms of natural fossil fuels like petroleum and raw material. A destination may not be sufficiently producing these things. So this may result in depletion of forest, fertile soil and fossil fuels. Pollution. It's a matter of grave concern worldwide. Now, due to the existing pandemic, when people were bound to stay at home, there were news reports within a month that said that people were able to breathe cleaner air What does this mean? This means when people go out, they spread pollution. They pollute air by means of their cars, vehicles in which they travel. There is a lot of vehicles, vehicular traffic on the road, which creates noise pollution, unnecessary honking of horns, which creates noise pollution. Construction of accommodation and facilities in an area that may create noise pollution. Water pollution. Where would the waste go? If the industries are running, where would the waste go? Why are the industries running? To create tourism can be a part of it. To create products for tourists. So where is the waste going? Generally, they secrete the waste into water, hence polluting water. Where is the sewage waste going from the accommodation units for tourists? It also goes into the water. Maybe after treating the water, but it doesn't make it drinkable. Littering of area, plastic, that has become a very grave concern in matters of soil pollution. It is not biodegradable. So it creates soil and land pollution. Tourism is a cause of destruction of ecosystem. How? Like we discussed earlier in the session, we need to create accommodation and accessibility options for the tourists. For that purpose, we need to cut forests, uproot trees, or at least shift them to some other location. What will it do? It has an adverse effect on environment because it destroys the natural habitat of the species indigenous to that area. Also, the pollution does the same thing to their habitat. Physical impacts, like I discussed earlier, that we need to create accommodation and accessibility option for the tourists. For that purpose, we need to construct. And construction can lead to loss of wildlife habitats, which we just discussed, and soil erosion, because it's a well-known fact. When you uproot trees, the soil becomes loose and hence can be eroded easily. We are a reason of deforestation and unsustainable use of land. The land which could be used to produce food grains and for other sustainable activities will now be used for accessibility option by construction of roads or accommodations. The negative effects of tourism, like pollution and other things, creates a global level impact. For example, depletion of ozone layer. Now, tourism may not be the sole reason for depletion of ozone layer, but it definitely had to play a part, because in tourism products like hotels and other subsidiaries, we have been using refrigeration and air conditioning. And earlier to the awareness of this ozone layer depletion, every refrigerant or air conditioning gases were made of chlorofluorocarbons, and because of which the depletion happened. Climate is changing. Most recently, the pink snow of Alps. You must have read about it. Now, if it does not snow amply, so what will happen to the ski destinations? Again, it will affect the tourism. And in fact, the environment is also getting affected. So it's vice versa also. There is a rise in sea level. So what will happen to the coastal areas? The beaches, they will drown gradually and affect the tourism. So if the tourism is affecting the environment, the vice versa is also going to happen. These are the references if you want to study it in detail. I hope I was able to summarize this. The negative impacts of tourism are quite more than the positive impacts. The day the positive impacts are more, we will be able to live in a better world. Thank you.